Good morning, folks. It was a beautiful night in Albuquerque as the clouds and sun played color connection. Caught a cloud burst there, and the rest of the night was pretty much lightning and wind. We're going to go over some more important weather stories today, including a huge notch on the belt of solar-triggered storms. We've got news above our heads, news beneath our feet. We'll look ahead a bit, but first we begin, as always, with spaceweathernews.com, checking out the last 24 hours on our star. Apart from the rotation of the sphere, the motion is lacking and the surface is relatively still. No big flashes of solar flares, and we don't expect there to be any today either as the blank sun marches on. But as most of you know, the sun going to sleep doesn't relieve the Earth of solar wind impacts from coronal holes, and that stream continued at Earth and even intensified since I saw you yesterday morning, driving geomagnetic storms that ended up reaching level 3 on some readers, especially in Europe. And folks, yet again, and as thousands of you heard predicted on Fly on the Wall over the weekend, a significant solar storm has seen a ramp up in tropical intensity, driving a low to reach tropical depression and then tropical storm status last night. Colin is the earliest sea-named storm in recorded history in this part of the world, and that's another record falling during a solar storm. Eyes open across the track, folks. It's here now. And folks, if you are just joining us over at earthchanges.org, scroll down in the last video on the left side, The Sun and Storms, breaks down exactly what we're talking about. Going to have to add this one to the list. Looking in 211 angstroms, we can see that the next coronal hole is eager to get in there from the top left, last one still lingering at the right at the limb. While no major quakes have taken place just yet, the uptick is peeking his head out this morning with multiple six-pointers over the last day, and uptick indications in the East Pacific as well. Don't forget that we are also nearly seeing a four-way alignment of Venus, Sun, Earth, and Saturn, and it's not like Mars is nowhere to be found either. Folks, everything we do is supported by suspiciousobservers.org, and just a reminder that the Thunderbolts Conference is about 2 weeks away. I speak Saturday morning the 18th, and all the details can be found at thunderbolts.info. We've got the global pressure and radar forecast, followed by shots of our star to close. It's 3:55 a.m. in the New Valley of the Sun. Eyes open, no fear. Be safe, everyone.